to on ascension na po na composites. To Honorable Secretary Salvador Panelo, Chief Legal Counsel and Presidential Spokesperson, Assistant Secretary Benjo Santos Benavides of the Department of Labor and Employment, Undersecretary Martin Dino of the Department of Interior and Local Government, and my dad, hi, His Excellency Ambassador Josef Bengse of the Embassy of Hungary, His Excellency Ambassador Nicolas Gallet of the Embassy of France, His Excellency Ambassador Koji Haneda of the Embassy of Japan, Her Excellency Ambassador Anke Reifenstuhl of the Embassy of Germany, Her Excellency Iana Sadiva, Chargé d'Affaires, Thomas Wersing, Delegation of the European Union to the Philippines, Director Javier Galvan of the Instituto Cervantes, members of the Diplomatic Corps, our ever-supported friends from the press, most especially our honorees and our awardees tonight. Sa ating pong mga kaibigan, mga kasama po namin sa FBCP at kasamahan sa industriya, magandang gabi po and thank you for coming out tonight. 4 years ago, in 2016, FBCP hosted the first Film Ambassadors Night in light of the resurgence of the impressive and not to mention historic recognition that Filipino films, filmmakers, and artists took home from various international film festivals that year. Dito po nanalo si Brilliant Jacqueline Jose para sa kanyang Pomidor in Cannes, Love Diaz for Babaeng Humayo. The year served as our humble effort to celebrate these recognitions at our own country, to show that yes, your own government and your own industry are here to honor your victories, because there is no better feeling than having your own to share that pride with you. Today, the Film Ambassadors Night serves as that same tradition and has continuously evolved into so much more. FAN, as we call it, has become a platform at the beginning of the year that gathers the industry to connect, share stories, and plan possible collaborations. You know, in other countries, whenever these filmmakers go out there and represent our cinema, they're alone. People don't know here from the Philippines how much our films are appreciated abroad. They go out there and represent not just their films, they not just themselves, but the Philippines. And this is our little way of just really showing them that nandito kami, nandito tayong lahat, at binibigyan silang pasasalamat dahil sa ginagawa nila going out there to represent our stories and our country. FAN has also provided an opportunity to showcase our amazing and thriving film industry to our government officials, our policymakers and executives, to allow them to appreciate our efforts and to inspire mutual support. Actually, it was also through FAN that partnerships have started with a different government agencies. Ngayon po, hindi lang po FBCP nag-iisa, hindi lang po kami under the office of the President. Kapartner din po namin ang DTI, kapartner po namin ang DOLE, we're partnering with DOT, we're partnering with the Office of the President and the Presidential Legal Council. All of them are seeing the importance of Philippine cinema, our film industry, and how our film industry is not just a contributor to the cultural appreciation and cultural endeavors of what we are doing now, but really also channeling that track of a commercial sustainability and a contributor to the economic sector of the country. For that, I am truly humbled and grateful that everyone continues to join us for the Film Ambassador's Night and recognizing that this is more than a celebration. It's a coming together, a unification of our industry with the hope of moving forward and progressing together as one towards a world-class audiovisual industry while keeping what makes Filipino films the unique and distinctive cinematic experience that it is. For 2019, Philippine cinema has literally traveled all over the world. from Russia to Egypt to Australia to Africa and back to Asia, Philippines is being represented and introduced to the world through cinema. A-list film festivals like Cannes, Carlo Vivari, Shanghai, Cairo, Tallinn, Tokyo, and Venice, each in their own selection of films. Last year, we had 8 films in Tokyo representing the different facets of Philippine cinema in our stories. We were in Cannes Film Festival, Ang Hupa by Lav Diaz was represented in the Cannes Fortnite section. In Carlo Vivari, the film Oda sa Wala by Dwayne Baltazar in the main competition. In Shanghai International Film Festival, Persons of Interest directed by Ralston Hover. In Tallinn Black Nights Film Festival, Kalel 15 by Jun Lana, where he also won Best Director, accompanied by films like Mañanita, John Denver Trending by Arden Rodcondes, Mindanao by Brillante Mendoza, Verdict by Raymond V. by Gutierrez. Tokyo, 8 films, Mañanita by Paul Soriano, Motel Acacia by Bradley Liu, Mindanao by Brillante Mendoza, Food Lore, Island of Dreams by Eric Mati, Quaresma by Eric Mati, 6 Degrees of Separation by Antoinette Hadaone, and Untrue by Sigrid Bernardo. And of course, in Venice International Film Festival, one of the top 3 festivals in the world, Verdict, directed by Raymond V. by Gutierrez, won the special jury prize in the Horizonte section of the festival. FDCP also led spotlight events in Osaka, Udine, and Canada in continued celebration of the 100 years of the Philippine cinema. They may not be A-list film festivals, but these festivals continue to become the platform of Philippine cinema because they always showcase and champion Asian films. We also supported and granted over 200 filmmakers, producers, and films in their participation in international film studies, project markets, international film festivals, and film markets. Led also 12 embassy-partnered Philippine posts. Ngayon po, even our Philippine embassies all over the world are doing their own Filipino film festivals. This year, we had 22 films in the Guanajuato Film Festival led by the Embassy of Mexico. And also 15 films in Lisbon, Portugal, led by Ambassador Cookie Feria. 3 weeks running, featuring 6 national artists for film. This is how our Philippine cinema is being appreciated and promoted all over the world. We cannot be prouder of how much our industry have grown to be globally competitive while staying true to our identity and cultural heritage. This is why, to show you how much we value and recognize this industry, FDCP is making every effort to further our support systems in all fronts. This is the perfect venue to officially announce that this year we are launching our audiovisual fund to support production of films. Film Philippines incentive programs like FLIP is aimed to provide financial incentive to foreign productions filming in the Philippines. ICOF, or International Co-Production Fund, for Filipino producers engaging in international co-productions. ACOF, for ASEAN co-produced films with Filipino producers. And PCOF, for local films that would allow us to provide and renew our funding support for our films that are aiming for domestic production. These, in addition to our continuing assistance programs that grant support to film festivals, local, regional, international, labs, project markets, napakahitik po ng suporta at tulong at pakikipag-collaborate ng ating ng FDCP sa lahat po ng ating mga filmmakers. And we won't be able to come up with all these programs if we don't see you going out there, really making films, and really striving to make better films. 2 days ago, meron pong isang landmark na achievement po ang FDCP na matagal na po namin nilalobby for the last 2 years. And I didn't imagine that it would actually happen during the celebration of the 100 years of Philippine cinema. 2 days ago, we had a landmark agreement between the Department of Labor and Employment in providing guidelines in the working conditions and occupational safety health standards for our audiovisual workers. You know, we may be competing in different festivals abroad. We may be promoting Philippine cinema in the different parts of the country and in the different parts of the world, pero kung hindi po natin naalagaan ang ating mga workers, mamamatay po ang ating industriya. Kaya, in the same way that we are giving this, creating these programs, these platforms to support our films, we also have to come up with policies, and we are enjoining our government to look into the situation of our film workers. They are the core of what film industry is about. They are the heart of why we are here as an industry. And I think it's their turn to be taken care of, to be looked after. They have sacrificed so much. And dami po, dugot pawis po, just because of their passion to make films, to make these films that are going the rounds in different festivals all over the world. This is their turn. And I want to take this opportunity to ask for the support of the entire film industry to please support us. It's one thing to create a standard. It's one thing. Sorry. It's one thing to make these guidelines. Pero kung hindi po natin ito susuportahan at hindi po natin bibigyan ng pagpapahalaga, ano na pong mangyayari sa ating industriya? They've given their share. They've given so much more than themselves. They live because they love this industry. And the only way for this to work is if we can enjoin our production companies, our producers, lahat po ng bumubuo sa industry ang ito para pangalagaan po natin ang ating mga manggagawa. I know that it's not going to be easy. I know that this is going to be tough for us. It's an entrenched system that has been going on in the last 100 years. And I know that it's going to take a while for us to get used to these new systems, these new standards. But ang goal po natin is makarating doon. FDCP is here to work towards partnerships, transitionary measures on how we can all work together. But please, let us not set this aside. It took so long for all those people who have lobbied for this to achieve this, to get this support from the government. The time of Lino Broca, you know, hindi po sa akin na, siguro napakaswerte ko lang po na ako po yung nakaupo ngayon at nagbigay ng ganitong klaseng, hindi po kami natinag, pero hindi lang po ako ito. People before me from the time of Lino Broca, even before, they have been aspiring and clamoring for this change. So, sana po, hindi lang po ito maging batas, hindi lang po ito maging polisiya. Marami na pong mga direktor, marami na pong mga iniidolo natin sa industriyang ito ang namatay, ang nawala, dahil hindi po natin ito binibigyan ng pagpapahalaga. So, I know, and I'm sorry I didn't really plan for this to become something that will become like a plea, but I want to take this opportunity to just really ask everyone. Naniniwala po ako at ang bottom of your, na sa kaibuturan po ng inyong mga puso, gusto nyo pong maging maayos ang industriya natin. Wala lang po tayong sistema. Wala lang po tayong standards. Pero ngayon, andito na po siya. So, sana po, ito na po. The next 100 years of Philippine cinema is going to be about this. Taking care of our workers, taking care of this industry, making sure that we can look forward to a more sustainable industry in the future. This is our gift. This is what the next 100 years of Philippine cinema is going to be about. And I hope that we can all join together para po pagtulungan po natin ang mas progresibo, mas maganda, at mas sustainable po na industriya at masayang industriya po para po sa ating lahat. Maraming salamat.